exhibition of Savate, the French method of the noble art of self-defense. Savate is different from English and American boxing because the contestants deliver blows not only with their fists, but also with their feet. Are you ready, gentlemen? Eh bien! Mademoiselle, that camera! You have blinded him!
Oh, I am sorry. Are you hurt?
Forget it. Be sure to take a picture of him when I break his neck.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victor!
Thanks. Thanks, everybody. Thanks. Oh, tell him it's safe to get up. I'm gonna take a shower.
And now, please, ladies and gentlemen, the bus is waiting to take us to the Royal Palace. If you will all come along, please. Quickly, please.
Wait! Wait! This man is dead!
Dead?
We must call the police!
The police? Quickly, please, ladies and gentlemen. Quickly! Once the police come, we will never get away. Quickly, please, quickly.
Quickly, please. Quickly.
Meet Miss Warner, please.
I'm coming.
Leave, monsieur.
Something's happened to Henri. I gotta call the police.
The police have already been called. I'm Inspector Hainaut.
What's wrong with him?
He's dead, Barry.
You're kidding.
I'm sure you didn't mean to kick him so hard.
Only knocked him out.
Savate is a dangerous sport.
Georges tells me that you are the son of the famous detective, Charlie Chan.
Yes. May I call him? He's expecting me to meet him.
Your father will be notified in due course. Please remain here, monsieur.
Inspector Hainaut, always great pleasure to meet old friend. You will join me, please.
And many thanks, Monsieur Chan.
I am very glad to have opportunity to introduce you to number one son, who is only now 12 minutes late for lunch.
I fear he may be later, Monsieur. I have just met your son at the gymnasium.
Ah, yes, gymnasium. He is most anxious to become expert in all methods of self-defense, now taking lessons in Savate.
And becoming perhaps too expert, there has been an accident.
Harry?
No, no, no. Your son is not hurt. His sparring partner, however, has been killed. As you will appreciate, all accidents resulting in death must be investigated.
Of course. Duty of police is very clear. Also, duty of father to hasten to son in trouble.
My car is waiting.
I can't believe it, Pop. I only knocked him out. Henri used to knock me out all the time, but it didn't hurt a bit.
How many times were you knocked out by Berger?
This week, 5 times. I'm only a beginner, Pop.
Did you resent these knockouts?
Resent them? Why?
Inspector Hainaut, as policeman, has right to ask questions.
If you mean, was I trying to get even with him? Well, yes, but I only meant to knock him out, not to hurt him.
This young man is speaking the truth, Pierre. It was a most unfortunate accident. As I said before, savate is a dangerous sport, even in practice.
Odette, please. Who killed him, George? Where is the man who killed Henri?
Odette, control yourself.
You must forgive my daughter. We only just heard.
Madame Dubois is my sister. Odette is my niece. I thought they should know what had happened.
Pierre, you tell me, who killed him?
This young lady was engaged to marry Henri.
He told me about her. Miss Odette, I had nothing to do with what happened to Henri. I was in the ring with him, but...
Then you are the one.
Young lady, please.
I am sorry to accuse this young man. It won't bring Henri back.
You may leave, monsieur, with your son.
No words can express adequate sympathy for loss of a loved one.
Monsieur's son, naturally, the investigation is not yet completed. Your son must remain in Brussels. You understand my duty, of course.
My son realizes his responsibility, Inspector. He shall remain in Brussels.
Oh, Pop.
Self-reproach does not solve problems. My number one son would be wise if he did not blame himself for an unfortunate accident. Sit over here.
Can you take a jolt, Pop?
In my long career, I've taken many.
What happened in the gym? I've got a hunch it was not an accident.
You mean you are confessing to murder?
Pop, you know I'm not. Henri was killed, but not by me. And what's more, he did not die in the ring.
Two coffees, please. Continue.
After I went to the shower, George couldn't bring Henri to right away. So I guess he got scared and jumped to the conclusion that he was dead and ran and phoned the police.
On what basis do you assume Henri Berger did not die in the ring?
Look, Pop, he was still lying in the ring when I went to the showers. When I came out, his body was clear over against the wall.
Most interesting. How do you account for this?
I don't know how to account for it. I only know the gym must have been empty for at least 5 or 6 minutes while I was in the showers. During that time, anybody could have come back and killed the poor guy. Maybe he put up a fight. Maybe that's why the body wasn't still in the ring when I came out again.
Your theory is most reasonable. Did you report same to police?
Not yet. I'm already in hot water.
If murder is suspected, you will be in boiling water. Good beginning now would be to locate witnesses.
What witnesses? The gym was empty.
No witnesses to your combat with deceased opponent?
Oh, yes. A party of tourists. A guide brings them in every day. But they all went out after I knocked out Henri.
Perhaps if we can locate these tourists, they would testify that body was in ring, not out of ring, when you left for showers.
The referee George can testify to that.
Would prefer others to back up referee's decision. Could you identify any of these tourists?
There's one I remember, an American girl with a camera. I told her to be sure to take a picture when I knocked out Henri. And I think she did.
Such a picture could be valuable. We must find this girl. Come.
Pardon me, I've just locked up for the night. To put it frankly, I have a dinner appointment.
But we want to find that beautiful girl you took into the gym today. You know, the one with the camera.
These tourists, they come, they go. I take them to the town hall, to the king's palace, to the gymnasium. Anywhere they can stand and gape. After that, they take off for the Alps, Italy, Paris, all over. I don't even know their names.
Nor names of hotels where they reside?
The bus starts from this office. Brings them back. That's all.
Look, when you got your party out of the gym, did you know there was an accident in the ring?
I did, monsieur. But it is my duty to protect my tourists from any delay in their schedule.
I'm afraid I'm a little early.
That's her, Pop. She's even got the camera.
Martin seems to have come to Mohammed.
Well, hello, Jock.
Hello, Mary.
Thought you didn't even know her name.
Her name, monsieur, is Mary Warner. And she's staying at the Palace Hotel until Thursday.
Why didn't you say so before?
It is against the rules of this company, monsieur, for a guide to have any social engagements with the tourists. I would like to take Miss Warner to dinner. I would also like to keep my job.
Have no fear. We shall keep your secret.
But in return, how about those pictures you took in the gym?
What about them?
Pop would like a set of prints.
Or at least address of camera shop.
Oh, I just picked them up. You can have them if you like.
Wait a minute. What's it all about?
Merely a simple request to look at what might be evidence. If you object, police order will get same anyway. Causing embarrassment to young lady and also to you.
All right. Give them to him.
Please, permit me to pay for same.
Oh, no.
Oh, thank you.
That's it, Pop.
Would prefer to study under enlargement. We'll rent a projector tonight.
Well, while you're finding the projector, I'm going back to the gym.
Oh, but for what reason?
Well, according to Dr. Soderheim, the best clues can be found on the scene of the crime.
But gymnasium now closed. This would mean illegal entry.
Not for me. I'm an honored guest. Well, at least I was until the day.
Most grateful for pictures. Hope you both have a very enjoyable dinner.
Just happened to be passing. I thought I'd take a look around.
The gymnasium is closed.
But what are you doing here, Inspector?
Monsieur Chan, the criminal often returns to the scene of his crime. You are under arrest.
But what for?
The official charge will be illegal entry into this gymnasium. The unofficial charge will be in connection with the death of Henri Berger.
No need to handcuff me, Inspector. I've already told you everything I know about the accident.
It was not an accident, monsieur. It was murder.
Murder? Pop, they threw questions at me all night. Especially that friend of yours, Inspector Renault. I guess he's a better friend of that girl, Odette.
You mean young lady who was engaged to unhappily deceased man?
Yeah, Henri Berger. But Henri told me the inspector was engaged to her once. Did you hear about the autopsy?
Yes. He died of a skull fracture.
And I'm the number one suspect.
A suspect must have more than opportunity to commit a crime. He must also have a motive.
They got that figured out, too. Three witnesses claim I threatened Henri's life in the ring yesterday.
What witnesses?
The referee, the tourist guy, and that gal with the camera.
Why do witnesses lie?
It's not a lie. Not exactly.
The wheels of your mind, my son, grind louder than the sound of your voice. What are you thinking?
I'm sorry, Pop. There's something I should have told you. But I didn't think it was important.
What was unimportant fact?
Well, the truth is I got sore at Henri, and I threatened to break his neck.
Very unfortunate you said that.
But I didn't mean it, Pop. Not the way they took it. Henri used to say the same thing to me. It's a running gag, a joke.
Old saying. Words in jest often lead to misunderstanding. Tell me, was proprietor of gymnasium on friendly terms with your opponent?
Far as I know, they only had one beef. George didn't want his niece to marry Henri.
Further inspection of beef may be necessary. Must learn whether same as prime beef, choice cut, or perhaps unfit for human consumption. Ah, Inspector Renault.
Charlie, as you requested, this is the order for the immediate release of your son on bail.
Oh, thank you.
You understand, of course, that he is still not free to leave Brussels.
Oh, of course.
You mean I can get out of this crowbar hotel?
Yippee!
You owe thanks, young man, to the fine reputation of your father.
Thanks, Pop.
He also owes thanks to his father's wallet. Bail, very expensive in Belgium. 50,000 francs.
Odette, you must get hold of yourself. You've got to go on living.
Madam, I deeply regret this intrusion.
How dare you come into this house?
My daughter has been very distressed. You must excuse her.
I understand and sympathize, therefore, will not detain you too long.
We just want to ask one question.
There have been so many questions from the police, even from our dear friend Inspector Renal.
With your kind indulgence, would like to know why your brother George objected to Henri Berger marrying your daughter.
It was about money. My husband left a small inheritance. I gave it to Henri as a dowry for his marriage to my daughter.
And your brother objected to the gift.
Georges wanted to invest my money for improvements in his gymnasium. Henri wanted to invest in a gymnasium of his own in Antwerp.
And did he?
Last weekend, he took a train there to invest the money. But two men robbed him on the train. They have not been caught.
And this is why your brother George got angry with deceased Mr. Berger.
My brother said that Henri was a fool to let himself be robbed. He said a fool should not be allowed to marry my daughter.
You disagree with him?
How can one stop the marriage of two young people in love? My brother's anger is simple to explain, if not to understand.
And the explanation, madam?
As I told you, Georges wanted to invest my money in his gymnasium. He was angered when I gave it to Henri, and more angered still when Henri lost it. I would like to comfort my daughter. Are there any more questions?
No more questions.
Just one thing. If that's the way your brother felt about Henri, then he didn't care much if Henri got killed, did he?
My number one son is very upset. Please excuse bluntness of his question. No need to answer. Most grateful. Good day. Now, which picture taken by American lady is which?
This is when Henri kicked me.
Next one?
And this is right after I kicked Henri.
Turn out lights. This seems to be the last picture taken by Miss Warner. Tourist already starting to leave.
And Henri Berger is still in the ring, see?
Very clearly. Now, this is newspaper picture taken just after arrival of police.
Look, the body's not in the same place. Those pictures prove he moved.
Please, my son, impatience sometimes is like a large stone in pathway, can trip you up. Put out lights again. Picture shows something of much greater importance.
What's that?
On close observation, you will notice wall with rack, having pairs of Indian clubs and dumbbells, two of each.
There's always two of each.
Now, in newspaper picture taken shortly after arrival of police, you see same wall, same rack, but one Indian club missing.
You tagged it, Pop. Henri was killed with an Indian club.
Pictures not only suggest possible murder weapon, but also possible user of same.
You mean those pictures gave you a clue to the guilty man?
Number one son should be more observant in looking at pictures.
Hello, Monsieur Jean. I was about to go home.
I sincerely hope I shall not be obliged to detain you too long, Mr. Leroux.
What happened to the other Indian club, the one that should be here?
I didn't even notice the club was missing. You see, since the death of Henri, there has been no business. The police have closed down the gymnasium.
Yes, I understand. Request permission to search, please.
Search for what?
Missing Indian club.
But why?
Reason will not be difficult to understand after we locate murder weapon.
Here in the gymnasium?
Pop said it has to be. The killer wouldn't run out with the murder weapon under his arm, and the police put a 24-hour watch on this place, so nobody could have gotten out with it.
This is Henri's locker. Have you no regard for the dead?
Regard for deceased is one reason for being here. Also concern over manner in which he met death.
Find something, Pop?
Very interesting.
Just a hotel bill. What's so interesting about that?
But notice situation of hotel, Monte Carlo, and dated last weekend.
Maybe he wanted to open a gym in Monte Carlo.
Or perhaps exercising roulette wheel, thereby reducing fortune.
I get it. He told Madame Dubois he was robbed on a train, but he was robbed by a roulette wheel.
One moment.
Pop, you found it.
Eager son must be careful of fingerprints.
How do you like that? The club's in Henri's locker.
Logical place for a killer to hide weapon in locker of victim. Telephone Inspector Renal. I would like to see him here at once.
Sure, Pop. sure fixed him, Pop.
Son's exhibition of savate most satisfying. Student has defeated trainer. Now you may complete so rudely interrupt the telephone call to inspect the runout.
Right.
But yes. Yes, of course. Yes, monsieur, we will leave at once. That was Pierre, Inspector Renal. He would like us to come to the gymnasium.
At this time of night?
Monsieur Charlie Chan wishes to ask more questions. Will they never end? Come, my dear, you must get dressed.
Henri wasn't killed in this ring. George came back to this place when it was empty and killed him with that club, clear over against that wall.
I did not kill him.
Perhaps Inspector Renard would like to hear the motive.
But of course.
The motive's simple. George's sister had a small inheritance. George wanted her to invest it in this gym, but she gave it to Henri, and he blew it at Monte Carlo.
You agree with the motive?
My number one son is partially right about the motive, but he is wrong about the person actually guilty of the crime.
Wrong? I don't get it, Pop.
Pierre?
Over here, madame.
Pierre, why have you asked us to come here?
At the request of Monsieur Chan. I presume for further questioning.
No questions, madame. Sincerely regret inconvenience.
Monsieur Chan, these ladies have been under great emotional strain. It is very unkind to bring them here for no purpose. My apologies, madame. You may leave.
One moment, please. Forgive me, Inspector. I said no questions. I did not say they could leave.
Why not?
Madame Dubois must be held for murder.
Madame Dubois?
Also, her brother, George Leroux.
You are mad, monsieur.
What are you getting at?
Hand that struck fatal blow was that of Madame Dubois. However, brother is also guilty under law, since they planned crime between them, as my number one son has already said. Henri Bergère went to Monte Carlo, lost fortune of Madame Dubois. This action made him unsuitable as husband for Odette, so Henry was killed. By you, madame.
How can you say such a thing?
Not very difficult. Seen through a magnifying glass, Inspector, this picture taken by a young American lady shows tourists going through door. But among them, who else do we see? Only side view of face, but identity of Madame Dubois is unmistakable. So retired Honolulu detective asks himself a question. Why does lady, resident of Brussels, join tourist group to visit gymnasium owned by brother? I find answer to question in murder of Henri Bergère.
But where does George come into it then?
When you kicked Henri and knocked him unconscious, Leroux shouted, "This man is dead," thereby clearing gymnasium of all people. When gymnasium was empty, Leroux returned, saw unconscious fighter, now partially recovered, staggering toward shower. There was a fight. Henry would have won, but Madame Dubois had returned, seized Indian club. And Henri Bergère was dead, in fact. I'm sure, Inspector, when you examine club, you will find Madame Dubois' fingerprints. Great pity innocent young lady is forced to suffer.
I'll look after her, Monsieur Chan. I cannot thank you enough for your help in this case. How can I hope to repay you?
I have two excellent suggestions. First, relieve my son of all charges. Second, wallet now very thin after bail bond. Would appreciate refund of same.
Of course. Might I make one friendly suggestion?
Please do.
In future, see that number one son adheres strictly to the American sports.
Most excellent suggestion. Upon return home, shall enroll him in rock and roll school.
What is this rock and roll?
Juvenile invention, substituting hips for brains. Only dangerous when location of brains is questionable.